When creating drawings of weldments, you may want to include details of individual components that are included in the cut list. Onshape now allows you to reference those views of individual components to their associated cut list items. This allows you to add item balloons to those items, making your drawings clearer and easier to understand. Working with general tables on your Onshape drawings just got faster when adding new data. Onshape now enables you to duplicate columns and rows by simply selecting a cell in the column or row you wish to copy, and then select Duplicate in either column or row. All of the data from that column or row will be copied, where you can quickly change any of those new values for the information needed. This will streamline the time it takes to create and edit general tables in Onshape. Previously, when releasing a product that has out-of-date drawings, Onshape has excluded those drawings from the release candidate. More importantly, Onshape was not able to provide information as to which drawings were out of date. In this release of Onshape, however, when creating a release candidate, Onshape now lists all of the associated drawings for your product and instead highlights any out-of-date drawings. You can use the Show Items That Need Attention button to filter these out-of-date drawings quickly. From there, you can simply click on each drawing, which will open it in its own browser window, where you can perform any necessary updates. Once the drawings have been updated, the entire release candidate can be refreshed, which will then include the recently updated drawings. This greatly streamlines the process of releasing your products and their associated drawings, eliminating the need to hunt down any missing documentation for the release candidate.
Now in Onshape Task Generation, we have the ability to share with an entire team or an alias defined using team members or individuals. Simply assign the task to the team or alias, and it will break it up into multiple members if it is an alias. You can also search on who is assigned based on team. Make sure you set this up in your administrative console or setting up teams in aliases with the appropriate members.
We've made a series of subtle but impactful UI improvements to the Documents page. Right off the bat, you'll probably notice the search bar has been centered in the header, which has been darkened and is now the same color as the sidebar, which is found in Enterprise Accounts, and a result of moving an entire menu. For those of you not on Enterprise, here's a quick comparison showing the new UI without the sidebar. In addition, the logos and icons are larger, dividers feature more spacing and distinct separation, and the footer details have been moved to the About menu. These changes help align the new design with the rest of the product, making everything feel more cohesive. Importing files just got easier. You can now drag and drop files directly onto the Documents page, just like you can, and likely do, in Google Drive. Whether you're uploading one or several, the workflow remains consistent. This intuitive change will help you get your files added to Onshape fast, but please note that folder imports aren't yet supported.
The Properties dialog just got a major usability upgrade in Onshape. Now, you can resize the dialog box to fit your workflow, giving you more room to view and edit part, assembly, and drawing metadata. The best part? Onshape remembers your preferred size. Every time you open the Properties dialog, it stays exactly how you left it. When changing view orientations, you may want to go back to the previous view. Onshape introduces Previous View from the Camera and Render Options dropdown. This new command will go back to the previous view orientation, while subsequent use of the command will toggle between the current view and the previous view. The new Previous View command can also be given a keyboard shortcut from your account preferences. This makes accessing the previous view even quicker.
A new air coolant setting has been added to CAM Studio Operations. You'll find it under the Posting section for any toolpath. This simple on-off option specifies whether external air coolant is used during machining. Perfect for operations where chip clearing or tool cooling is needed without liquid coolant. Render Studio's function workflow just got a big usability boost. Previously, attaching functions like noise, blend, or texture maps was done through the lower library panel, and that workflow still works exactly the same. But now, You can also use the right panel library for even faster drag-and-drop function attachment. Here's how it works. You can drag a noise function directly onto a material's bump input to create texture variation, or drop a color blend function onto the base color slot to combine procedural layers instantly. No extra clicks required. This update streamlines how you manage and connect visual functions, making Render Studio faster, more flexible, and even more intuitive for building complex materials.
To take better advantage of the vast real estate on modern mobile devices, the Onshape user interface now expands across the top of the toolbar on iPad and creates categorized lists on the iPhone for vertical environment. The search tool is now always at your fingertips as well for searching for commands.